Now, in other news, cyber authorities are working closely with their Chinese counterparts to identify China-based hackers who planted spyware in Philippine government websites. This report.
Not your everyday hacking attempt, but likely spyware attacks. That's how the Department of Information and Communications Technology described the latest attempts by hackers to infiltrate several Philippine government websites and emails, which the agency thwarted in January. DICT Undersecretary Jeffrey E.N.D. said the attackers made use of various tactics to cover their digital tracks, similar to how spyware attacks are done. Whereas other groups like those behind the Medusa ransomware against state insurer PhilHealth or the hacking of the Philippine Statistics Authority even advertised their nefarious schemes. But the DICT clarified this does not automatically mean that the motive behind the failed cyber attacks was espionage.
Spyware ang ginamit, kaya nga ho, one of the possibilities is pwede ho nga to gain access doon sa mga administrator para ho naman makagain further access doon sa systems. We cannot attribute talaga ano yung motibo.
The agency earlier said it had traced the internet protocol or IP address of some hackers to China Unicom, a Chinese state-owned telecommunications operator. But according to Dee, the DICT has no direct evidence pointing to the Chinese government's involvement in the matter. In fact, is even working with Beijing to go after the threat actors.
Tayo naman ho, eh, nakikipagtulungan by giving them the information na nakuha natin. Maasa tayo na sila naman sa parte nila since they have primary jurisdiction at kontrolado nila yung teritoryo nila. Maging totoo sila doon sa kanilang pahayag na hindi nila hihahayaan at hindi nila ikinukundun ganito mga aktibidades. Oh.
Among the government agencies targeted by hackers are the websites of the DICT, Philippine Coast Guard, the Overseas Workers Welfare Administration, and even the webpage of President Ferdinand Marcos Jr. Andrea Taguines, ABS-CBN News.
Cybercrime investigators and Japan's embassy in Manila are trying to identify a supposed Japanese national who sent multiple bomb threats to state-run schools and offices in the Philippines. Jeff Caparas reports.
Employees of the social security system in Lucena and Negros Oriental were sent home early after their office received a bomb threat on Monday. Work at the office of the Environment Department was also disrupted, while schools in the whole Bataan province were cancelled due to the same threat. A subsequent security sweep of the facilities showed the bomb threat to be false alarm. The bomb threats all came in through email from a single sender identified in the messages as Takahiro Karasawa. This isn't the first time this name was connected to similar threats. In 2021, a bomb hoax was sent to various institutions in Taiwan, Korea, and Japan. That same year, Japan conducted an investigation where a person identified as Takahiro Karasawa presented himself to authorities. He claimed he was a victim of identity theft. On September 2023, government agencies in the Philippines received a similar email. The Cybercrime Investigation and Coordinating Center said they were informed that Malaysia also received the same email on Monday.
We have full details of this spread of malicious information that has affected several government agencies. In NCR alone, 28 government agencies have received this form of email from a foreign national from Japan.
In a recent joint interagency conference, officials from relevant security agencies discussed the bomb hoax, along with a representative from the Japanese embassy. For now, the CICC is advising employees of government agencies not to forward such email. And if they receive a threat, they are advised to immediately inform their supervisor, while the public is encouraged to reach out to the police. Meanwhile, the Philippine National Police says they are coordinating with other law enforcement agencies outside the country.
As of now, I don't see any motive. I don't see any personal gain or any gain from that individual, except for creating unnecessary, disturbances, especially sa mga estudyante natin. Kawawa naman yung mga estudyante na sususpend ang classes because of this unwanted actions.
As for the Bureau of Immigration, the agency has ordered a thorough investigation on the identity of the perpetrator. This includes validating the whereabouts of the suspect and verifying the real identity of the bomb hoaxer. Tansinko adds, a quick check on their database revealed at least 4 namesakes, and all of them are currently not in the country. The National Bureau of Investigation, for its part, is collaborating with the Japan Police Attaché, other law enforcement agencies, and emergency responders to comprehensively evaluate the threat. Jeff Caparaz, ABS-CBN News.
Vice President Sara Duterte, unfazed by claims she's among the respondents of the International Criminal Court's alleged case over her father's bloody drug war. Joyce Balancho reports.
Vice President Sara Duterte maintained that she is not bothered to be among the alleged respondents in a case pending before the International Criminal Court or the ICC. This after she sought legal advice on the matter.
Well, sa akin, hindi, I cannot speak for the other members of the family. Sa akin, hindi naman kasi nakakakuha din ako ng legal advice sa mga Filipino lawyers na merong alam about international law.
She says she has not spoken yet to her father, former President Rodrigo Duterte, who is also a subject of the ICC investigation. Recently, former presidential spokesperson Harry Roque said former President Duterte is aware that a warrant of arrest may be issued against him.
Doon naman ako, meron siguro siyang mga kausap na mga abogado dahil abogado din naman si Pangulong Duterte. So naiintindihan niya yung mga legal implications at mga procedure sa ICC.
The Vice President also says she has no plans of pursuing legal charges against self-confessed gunman Arturo Las Cañas, who linked her to alleged series of extrajudicial killings in Davao City when she was the mayor.
Wala akong balak magsampa ng kaso sa kanya. In fact, siya yung china-challenge ko na magsampa ng kaso sa akin ng murder doon sa Pilipinas.
Duterte refused to comment on a lawmaker's request that she talk to her father and brother and convince them to reconcile with President Marcos. Her father has called for Mindanao's independence, but the vice president asserts she is focused on the development projects there.
Wala akong comment sa politika, no, because everyone can go their way sa politics. But sa development projects naman doon sa Mindanao, ay tinututukan natin kamakailan lang nandun si Pangulong Marcos sa Davao City para ipresenta yung transport modernization ng Davao City and of course yung iba pang mga development projects sa iba pang lugar sa Mindanao.
Meanwhile, Vice President Duterte had a jam-packed schedule in Malaysia on Tuesday. She visited a vocational college in Kuala Lumpur where she learned of the Early Childhood Development course. This, she says, is a good program that Philippines can adopt.
Ito yung mga babies hanggang 4 years old na mga bata na pwede nang turuan at pwede nang i-catch ng ating mga teachers para masimulan yung pag-aalaga at pagtuturo sa kanila.
She says DepEd can begin studying the program in coordination with the Early Childhood Care and Development Agency. Duterte also paid a courtesy call on Education Minister Fadlina Sidek. In her brief meeting with the official, she expressed her gratitude for Malaysia's support for her presidency in the Council for the Southeast Asian Ministers of Education Organization, or the CIMEO. Duterte also observed the facilities of the CIMEO Tropical Medicine Regional Center, where some Filipino doctors and scientists pursue research on microbiology, parasitology, and entomology. She also lauded the programs of the CIMEO Regional Center for Education in Science and Mathematics and the Regional Center for Special Educational Needs. Duterte capped off her Malaysia visit with a meeting with the leaders of the Filipino community. Joyce Balancho, ABS-CBN News, Kuala Lumpur, Malaysia.